dominant, earth-shattering, epic, legend. These are all words associated with Kenenisa Bekele. For almost two decades now, Bekele has cemented himself as quite possibly the greatest distance runner of all time. But which race has made him so memorable? In this video, we'll be counting down my top 10 races of Kenenisa Bekele throughout his career. But before we dive into these amazing races, make sure to subscribe and check out my new podcast on Spotify. I'll put the link to the pod down below. At number 10, we have the 2003 World Championships over the 10,000 meters, where Bekele beat Haile Gebrselassie for the very first time. This was really a passing of the torch from Gebrselassie to Bekele, as previously, Gebrselassie had been the world's greatest distance runner. However, in this race, Bekele really did take on that role with an amazing performance of 26 minutes and 49 seconds. This performance was a full 23 seconds faster than the previous championship record, and Bekele was now on the map as the person to beat. At number 9 is the 2006 World Indoor Championships over the 3,000 meters. Now, you might not know this race, as I was actually unaware of it until now, but this performance was a true testament to Bekele's abilities. With 600 meters to run, Bekele made a strong surge and he never looked back. From 600 meters to the finish line, runners chasing down Bekele, such as Eliud Kipchoge, only got farther and farther away. Bekele only got quicker, and he ended his race with a final 200 meters of 26.8 seconds. This time was certainly extremely quick, however his final kilometer, which he ran in 2 minutes and 23 seconds, shocked even the announcers who were truly surprised at this time. At number 8 is the 10,000 meter world record performance from 2005. Looking back at this race, it's simply amazing to see Bekele in such incredible form. With a finishing time of 26 minutes and 17 seconds, Bekele averaged just over 63 seconds per lap. This pace was absolutely incredible, however Bekele's final 400 meters was run even faster as he ran a time of 57 seconds. Bekele was so effortless and so graceful in this race, and it was very evident that he was unbeatable. And number 7 is the 2007 World Championships in the 10,000 meters. Competing against Salishi Sahin and Martin Mathathi, Bekele was really tested in this race. Over the final 800 meters, Bekele looked to be in serious trouble. At one point, Bekele was about 5 meters behind the leaders, and it really did seem as though he was being dropped. However, in classic Bekele fashion, his final 400 meters would be his saving grace, as he ran an unbelievable final lap of 55 seconds.
The victory is third straight World Championship gold.
This finishing kick made him yet again the world champion, and he finished it in style with a final kilometer of 2 minutes and 30 seconds. And number 6 is the 5,000 meter world record from the 2004 FBK Games. This race was set up as a world record attempt exclusively for Bekele. Through the first mile, he ran a time of 4 minutes and 4 seconds, and through the 2,000 meter mark, he split a time of 5 minutes and 5 seconds. At this point, Bekele was already completely alone, and through the last 3,000 meters, it was a complete one-man show. With yet another impressive final lap of 58 seconds, Bekele showed the world that he was king. Finishing with a time of 12 minutes and 37 seconds, Bekele cemented himself as the best 5,000 meter runner in the world. Another fascinating fact about this race is that his final 3,000 meters, which is 7.5 laps, was completed in 7 minutes and 32 seconds. Coming in at number 5 is the 2008 World Cross Country Championships. In this race, Bekele actually lost his shoe at the 6-minute mark, and you can see in this clip right here where he stopped in order to put his shoe back on. This caused Bekele to fall back almost a full 50 meters, but with great patience and confidence, Bekele slowly and methodically brought himself back to the lead. Right around the 30-minute mark, Bekele made a strong acceleration, and nobody could keep up with his pace. Chasing down Bekele in this race was Leonard Comon and Zersne Tedese, but they had absolutely no response to Bekele's move. This race would be Bekele's final cross-country victory, and it solidified Bekele as the greatest cross-country runner of all time. And number 4 is the 2009 World Championships in the 5,000 meters. In this race we had not only Bekele, but Bernard Lagat, Eliud Kipchoge, and Mo Farah. This race was rather tactical up until the final mile, when the pace started to increase rather drastically. However, the final lap, once again, would be a mad dash to the finish line, and Bekele was up front through the entire last lap, pushing the pace. What made this race so incredible is that Bernard Lagat, who is the second fastest 1500 meter runner of all time, was simply unable to keep up with Bekele's kick down the final home stretch. At the time, Bernard Lagat's kick was extremely respectable, and it seemed as though he was going to pass Bekele with about 50 meters to go. However, once again, Bekele unleashed another gear and passed Bernard Lagat to the finish line. At our number 3 position is the 2013 Great North Run. In this race, we had Haile Gebrselassie along with Mo Farah competing against Bekele. For many people, this is quite possibly the greatest road race of all time, as we had three of the greatest distance runners to ever walk the earth. With 1 mile to go, Bekele made a strong push forward, dropping Haile Gebrselassie, and it seemed as though he had dropped Mo Farah. However, Farah did not go away. With a final 400 meters of 60 seconds, Bekele was able to hold off a closing Mo Farah and run right at 60 minutes for the half marathon.
Got it by 2 meters, surely, and look at the clock just outside the hour, and Mo Farah there, raising his game just a few seconds too late.
Since this race, Mo Farah has made it a point to win the Great North Run, as he has won this race 6 straight times. But it's unquestionable that in 2013, Bekele made his presence known on the roads. At number 2 is the 2019 Berlin Marathon. Now, we've covered this race many, many times on this channel, so I won't go through every single detail, but based on his previous 2 years before this race, I believe you could argue that this is quite possibly the greatest marathon comeback of all time. It's one thing to go from 20 seconds behind the leader to winning by over a minute, but it's also another thing to completely rewrite your marathon narrative. And of course, he only ran 2 seconds behind Eliud Kipchoge's world record, which was both unbelievable and very much not expected. And coming in at the number 1 spot is the 2008 Olympic 5000 meter final. This race is unbelievable. Bekele was not going to lose, and he made it known in incredible fashion. Over the final 5 laps, Bekele made his move to the front, and he never relinquished this pace. For his final mile, Bekele ran a 3:58, and for his final 2000 meters, which is 5 laps, he ran a time of 4 minutes and 57 seconds. This performance was really strength and speed personified, as Bekele clearly could have run much faster as he ran his final lap in 53 seconds. Because of this unbelievable performance at the highest level, I can't help but choose the 2008 Olympic 5000 meter final as Kenenisa Bekele's greatest race ever. Do you agree with this list? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.